hostilities go. Let us know that we can spend time in prayer, reading the Bible, and to refocus our thinking on His perspective on whatever situation we have. Help us, dear Father, to be receptive to the information that's imparted to us this morning. Help us be better citizens in our city, in our county, in our state, and these are United States in an effort to make this a better place to live. Let us say together, amen.
Thank you. And do we have anyone here for the first time this morning that would like to introduce themselves? No? Okay. Then without further ado, I'll introduce our speaker, Mr. Michael Norman with Global Vocational Training Center. Thank you. And the way the forum will work is you'll do your presentation, and then if people have questions, they'll raise their hand, and we'll be calling upon them in the order that we see their hands, but not until you have completed your presentation. Thank you for being here.
Good morning.
Yes.
Good morning. How's everybody doing this morning?
Good.
Again, my name is Michael Norman. I'm the founder of Global Vocational Training Center located here in Charlotte, North Carolina. What I'm going to do this morning, I'm going to show you a brief video that we put together, and then I'm going to tell you deeper about Global Vocational Training Center. And then we're going to have a Q&A, and then I have another short video. So we're going to get started with this video.
Light in my throat now. them in the electrical trade. I look forward to showing them what it takes to be an electrician, how to be a craftsman, how to have pride in your work.
Okay, someone turn the lights on. Okay, for those that just arrived, my name is Michael Norman. I'm the founder of Global Vocational Training Center here in Charlotte, North Carolina. Global Vocational Training Center is a trade school. The program is 6 months long. And we do take veterans, dislocated workers, anybody that's looking for a trade, or anybody that's looking to change jobs and get into the trade field. I believe that the trade is the quickest way to own your own business. I'm speaking from experience. Also, I believe that the trade is the quickest way to bring a community out of poverty. I go to the jail every Sunday and do Bible studies in Jail Central downtown. During orientation, they told me that over 80% of the population in Mecklenburg County Jail is African American. Blew my mind. Knocked me off of my feet. And I'm asking myself, why are people only building screaming to the top of their lungs about this? Why ain't more programs set up that's going to help the revolving door, stop the revolving door of incarceration? So this is my solution. This is what empowered me to open a trade school so that when you come out of jail or out of prison, the re-entry program, that not only, and I call it the three E's, not only are we going to educate them, because if I educate you, and if I empower you, and if I don't, empower you, then you're still going to have a problem, because you're going to start making money, and this money may get too good to you if you're not empowered to do the right thing. So we came up with the three E's at Global Vocational Training Center, to where we educate, empower, and employ. So when they come out of jail, we supply education through electrical training, HVAC training. Next year we're going to bring fiber optics and solar. And the good thing about Global Vocational Training Center is that I am an electrical contractor, been an electrical contractor here in Charlotte since 2003. I own an electrical contracting business, and I have met a lot of business owners on my journey towards my destination. So when they finish after the 6 month program, I'm able to guarantee them a job with my company, or I can get other companies, Local Union 379. We have partnered with Aerotech that has connection with other electrical companies or HVAC companies. So we're able to offer them a job, and the empowerment part come in to where we bring in business owners, we bring in financial advisors. I bring in my financial advisor from Edward Jones to talk to them about opening a checking account. We bring in Fifth Third managers to talk to them about how to handle your money, how to open up a checking account, a savings account, how to make the most out of your money work for you without using it the wrong way. That's the empowerment part. I bring in business owners, preferably black business owners that's doing good in Charlotte, come in and talk to them about the journey that they're going through, that they can make it by mentorship, bring them in to mentor these guys. This young man right here came out of jail. He came to me in November of 2018. And the class was going to start in January of 2019. And what I usually do, I put him in the class, and after 3 months, if they really need a job, I put him out there with my guys. And he came to me in November. He said, "Mr. Norman," he said, "I got a family for you. I just got out of jail. I got a baby to take care of. I got a family for you." He said, "Mr. Norman, I need a job." So I went ahead and put Prince on. If you look on your card, the back on your card, you will see Prince. This is a job that we did for Mecklenburg County. This is Prince right here. So I went ahead and hired Prince. Prince just recently got a raise. He will be with me a year coming up in November. So he's doing fine. He's taking care of his family. We're feeding him positive energy. We empowering him. He's educated. He's on time at class. He's doing good on his tests. And all these young men that you see here, not all of them has been in jail or come out of jail, but the majority have. And a good thing that I like to see is their excitement. You can see their excitement in their face that I got a trade. My daddy's an electrician. Once they finish the school after 6 months, we give them $400 worth of tools. We give them everything that they need, to succeed out there as an electrician's helper. If they come into class not knowing anything about electrical, they're going to leave Global Vocational Training Center as a top helper. They will be able to read blueprints. They will be able to wire, basic wiring. They will be able to bend conduit, bend pipe. They will be able to recognize the tools. Not only do we have tests, written tests, but we also have skill tests to where I take them into the lab and they got to prove to me that you know how to read a multimeter, you know how to bend conduit, you know how to recognize different types of wire sizes, you know how to install a ceiling fan, you know how to install receptacles, install switches, you know what type of wire would go to what type of this particular application. You're going to know all that, or you're not going to leave the school. If I got to keep you here for 3 years, you're going to know what you're doing. Because electrical is very serious. We use the NCCER curriculum, the same curriculum that Goodwill and Urban League use. But we take it to another level, because I guarantee when my guys come out, when they get on the job, that the electrician will be really comfortable with my guys. Because they got on-the-job skills training. I specialize in setting up a lab where these guys can get their hands on it, where these guys can know what a number 12 wire looks like, what a number 14 wire looks like, where it goes, what a receptacle is, how to wire it, how to bend conduit. When you go on the job, when an electrician asks you to go get this particular tool, you'll know what he's talking about. We're going to start HVAC in September. And we got an instructor to do HVAC. He has his own business. I look for only gurus instructors. You've got to have your own business here in Charlotte, North Carolina to be an instructor for a Global Vocational Training Center. Not only is that going to have a pipeline for work for when the guys leave, but I want the gurus. Not only you've got to follow the curriculum, but you've got to know what you're talking about. You've got to give your experience. You got to give your experience to empower these guys to want to come to class. So Global Vocational Training Center is located at Albemarle Road, 4921 Albemarle Road, Suite 203. We're also working on setting up another school in Morgan, North Carolina, outside of Wadesboro. We want to empower that town. We want to set up a school there. I'm also looking at Baltimore. I really want to go to all the distressed areas in the United States. I really want to set a fire in my community so that they will empower their communities in order to set up more of these so that we can see that revolving door of incarceration go down. So that we can see our young men, women too, we got women coming in the September class. These guys right here graduate July the 12th. I'm going to send out an invitation to their graduation. They're doing very good. They're feeling good about themselves. So Global Vocational Training Center is offering, again, electrical, HVAC. Next year we're going to be offering fiber optics and solar installation and solar technicians. We're looking for anybody that's want a trade, veterans, dislocated workers, anybody that's looking to change jobs. We are educating people, we are empowering, and we are employing people. You gotta excuse me. I lost my train of thought. Any questions? Any questions?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Tommy.
All right.
I commend you on your program and your effort. How many people are you training now? And is this...
Can't hear you.
What?
Can't hear you.
It's not working.
It's working.
How many?
It's all together. You got to talk together into it.
Yeah. Okay. That's my train of thought. But anyway, I commend you on your effort in training. How many people do you have in your program so far? And how many do you expect to have?
This program right here, we have 10.
Could you repeat the question for everybody?
Oh, yes. You don't know how many people do I have in the program, how many am I expected to train in the next session? This class right here has 10. There's a couple of them missing here that came late. There's one guy that his dad, 14 years old, brought him to me. He said, I want you to train my son. 14 years old, and we signed a consent form, and his son is top number 3 in my class. Sharp, very sharp. So we have 10 this session that's going to graduate July the 12th, and we suspected because we got a new space, so we're holding 2 spaces now on Albemarle Road. We got this space, and we got another space in another building, so I'm suspecting 30 to graduate. Tuition costs for these guys, I tell them on the front that they don't have to pay. They don't have to pay. I get the money. Behind the scenes, we have a partner. The reason why I say that. Wow, he just bitch. Oh my. Reason why I say that is because we have partnered with Sword of Spirit Outreach, which is a 501c3 organization. You can go to the website, swordofspirit.com, and you can donate to swordofspirit.com, which supports Global Vocational Training Centers. We are going to churches. We are going to business owners. And International Electrical Solution also supports Global Vocational Training Centers.
Their dead-end jobs where they're mistreated because of their status of an ex-convict or ex-felon. And their hindrance is that most of these programs are during the working hours. So do you have flexibility in your classes or your sessions?
Yeah. Thank you for that question. That was my train of thought that I lost. The program, in the evening time, it starts at 5:30. And we go until 9 p.m., 5:30 until 9 p.m. That way some of the guys do work with International Electrical Solutions. They do work for me, so they work in the day and they're able to come to class at night.
So we had a few people that came in late, so let me just reiterate the rules one last time. So if you have a question, just raise your hand, get some sort of acknowledgement from me, and we'll have a list going and we'll come around with the microphone. So are there any other questions?
Yeah. Is this the beginning of an apprenticeship program? Because we all know that it takes longer than 6 months to learn electrical business. So are you training them to go into as apprentice in other corporations or businesses?
We mostly train at NCCER, National Center of Construction Research Curriculum, does have a apprenticeship training program. But we, like you said, it takes longer than 6 months. The educational part is 6 months. I can give them enough information in 6 months that I can guarantee that they can come out as a top helper if they know nothing about electrical when they come to this program. Now, once they get out, then we will put them out in the field and start them on their journey towards being an electrician. They can come back to Global Vocational Training Center and take the skills test for electrician. But we have to send them to another location to take the test for electrician. And then after they get their electrician license and they're out in the field for a while, then we are training them to be a business owner, to be electrical contractor, to take that electrical contractor test here in Charlotte, North Carolina, because I got the information, I showed them what I did in order to pass the test. I gave them training, I gave them a study guide so that they can study and make sure that they are ready with the skills to take the electrical contractor test. So the purpose is to start you off if you know nothing about electrical from the bottom, graduate, top helper, get out in the field with my guys and start working, and taught your electrician license, then start working towards being an electrical contractor owning your own business.
Mr. Norman, thanks for being here. My question is, in reference to your company, how many employees do you have? And you may have mentioned it earlier because I came in a little bit late. How long have you been in business, and where did you get your foundation from?
I got my foundation here in Charlotte, North Carolina. I come from Brevard, North Carolina, outside of Asheville. And I came down to Charlotte, North Carolina from a very dark place. I came to Charlotte with 35 cents in my pocket, and I stayed in the shelter for a while. And I was about to give up to, and I stayed in with George Shin's shelter then. And I stayed, and I slept on the floor because it was at capacity, and stayed at capacity during that time. And I went on that progressive journey to where I started working for the local Union 379 Electrical. And I started working, I started working, I started working. I said, wait a minute, I can do this. I can have my own company. And if I was a passion in me, because I hung out with the old school, my dad's friends, to empower the community. So it was always in me. So I wanted to open my own business so I can empower my community and make a difference in my community. So I started working for the local union, and I went and took the electrical contractor's test. I studied, me and his brother from Duke Energy, he was an engineer. We studied and studied and studied, and when two people go take that test, it's either one of them pass or both of them fail, and we both pass. We both pass. Praise God, we both pass. So when I passed the test, I started working as an electrical contractor in 2003 here in Charlotte, North Carolina. I started out small, made a lot of mistakes that I could show them, don't do this, get you an accountant, don't do this, if you start your own business, made a lot of mistakes. I've been working since 2003. Right now, today, I have 12 temp employees and 6 permanent employees.
Thank you, sir, for the awesome work that your organization does. My question is, the people in your program, do they find you or do you find them? How does that work?
It's a two-way street because my best advertisement is these. And their friends are calling me. Mothers are calling me. Grandmothers are calling me. Even though Ms. Diana Davis is out there doing a lot of workforce. Thank you, Ms. Diana Davis. But it's a two-way street. Two-way street. That's why I would like for y'all to come out of school, just peep your head in. Talk to these guys. Listen to them. That's my best advertisement.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My roommate is actually from Brevard, North Carolina. I thought it was less than two black people from up there.
We're about five.
Yeah, okay, well, you guys, you guys are explore, but anyway, my question is, as far as once they graduate, achieve the certification of being an electrician or getting their HVAC credentials, what is the capital needed for to get out and start your own business? Is it just enough with the knowledge of what kind of materials or tools do you need, and how much would that be?
It varies. We give them $400 worth of tools once they graduate, and that's a lot of tools, even open up your own business if you do it right. I always tell them about the journey on how I did it real time. Once they get their license, number one, make sure before you go out and do any type of electrical work, make sure you've got an electrical contractor's license. That's what I tell them. I say, I know you guys are excited, but don't go out there and solicit yourself as an electrical contractor until you take the test. So once they take the test, I usually tell them to start off small, even in your neighborhood. Print out business cards. Go door to door in your neighborhood and say, introduce yourself. Tell them that you're an electrical contractor. Write your license number on the business card so people will know that you are legit. Start off in your neighborhood. Everybody always need a ceiling fan installed, some new lights in your kitchen, some under cabinet lights. Everybody needs something electrical done. That's where I started off. I didn't even have a car. And I started off in my neighborhood, walking door to door. So I told myself I had to figure out how am I going to do this without a vehicle? What is going to be my sales pitch? Okay, I got it. I can do a better job than a man that has 10 trucks, but I will do it at half price if you come and pick me up. I will do it at half price. I didn't need to get one. I just need one. And once I got that first one, it was a snowball. They were coming to my door, picking me up. I would put the tools in the back of their car, drive to their house, and I would do an excellent job. People want you to get in, don't tear up their house, do a good job, be respectful, and get out. That's what I tell them.
You're getting right.
I told you I got my first truck. I was doing the job for a guy, and he had an old Ranger. I seen him sitting in the back, and the wheels were growing up around and everything. And I said, what you gonna do with that truck back there? Ford Ranger, black Ford Ranger. Had a camper on the back. He said, I tell you what, you can ride this house, you can have that truck. I'll ride that house. Got that truck. We got that truck. Charge it. No problem. Come on, 3 speeds. We were everywhere. Matter of fact, that truck bought the F-150.
Good morning. You may have touched on this already, but you talked about how you're training people for electrical work. Is there any component to the program that trains them to open up their own business, or maybe even encourage them to partner together to open up business to build that capital within our community?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we got a special curriculum that I have injected into the program, something special for me. I'm not going to put it out here right now because this is special with Global Vocational Training Center, to where the first thing that I have them to do is start writing their business plan. Okay? I bring in some managers from Fifth Third Bank, talk to them about their business plan. And you're going to see some of this in the next video I'll show you. And we talk to them about their business plan. So when they leave Global Vocational Training Center, they got a full-blown business plan plus other information that they need. First, you got to get to that electrician before you get to that contractor. So we got information that does a road, a clear road. Only obstacles is going to be is what you created. We're going to help you with the natural things that happen, that may happen. I'm going to help you with that. But there's a clear road to an electrician. There's a clear road to being an electrician. And then after you get the electrician, there's a clear road that we set up, that I have personally written, to get to an electrical contractor. The test, how to study, what to study, how to take the test, how to keep your mind clear during the study, because you got to eat, sleep, and think electrical when you're ready to take that electrical contractor's test. So we give them all that information to where they can open up their own business. Plus, we give them the law of electrical contracting, how to handle finances. We got our mentors that will mentor them for as financial. My accountant comes down and talk with them about if you want to open up a business, please get an accountant, even if you start small.
Want to know, have you partnered with any city resources or the Goodwill Center to kind of magnify your message?
No, because we are still new but old. I used to teach for Goodwill on mid-program. I was an electrical instructor for Goodwill when it was over off of Freedom Drive. On mid, I was an instructor for them. Did some training on Bakersfield Road. Bakersfield has a program. Did some training with that. But we are new and we're looking at partners. We had a meeting with Kevin Dix from the city. We met with him. So we got positive hopes that we can connect with the city and the city will support this just as well as we support the city. Because the main thing is to pull all of this into the city that you can see a change in distressed neighborhoods and distressed people. People that's coming out of jail positive. I want to do right. I want to do something. And then they get out here and they got to support. Oh, you said you was going to get a job. You said you was going to buy some milk, some Pampers. Well, honey, I'm trying to get a job, but I got a felony on my record, and everybody's closing the door in my face. I can't get a job. Well, what you going to do? You have to do something. You said that you were going to do something. He's real positive. He got that positive energy, and I'm trying. Doors are closing. So he gets discouraged. He got to make a move. He got to make a move fast. It's a short time from when they get out of jail until making that move. And when they make that move, they back into the system.
Yep.
And they make that move because of the fear that I can make it happen this time. I can do something different this time. I'm not going to do it the way I did this time. I'm going to do it this way, that way. I might get by with it doing this way. So they back into the revolving door of incarceration. So we're going to supply a way. If you come to me and I see that you're going to school, that you're doing right, and after 6 months, if you got a felony on your record, I will hire you. I own the company. Who says I can't? There are certain jobs that we can't put them on, but there are also jobs that we can put them on to support their family. Any other questions?
Yeah. Have you been doing this long enough to have any success stories that you could tell us about?
Yes, I got success stories. That video that we just showed you, three of my guys, we always do videos after the graduation class. The best success story are these guys. So if you guys want to hear really good success stories, come to the school. We got 5 until 9 p.m. Don't talk to me. Talk to them. I can sugarcoat it. Talk to them. Call me and ask me where we're working at with some of the guys that used to be in my class so that you can go out on the job site and see how they're working, see what they're doing, see how they learn anything. I challenge you to do that.
I love your program.
Thank you.
I think it's awesome. And I hope that you continue to grow it where there are places that need it. But my name is April Benson with Mecklenburg Council of Elders. All your felons and everybody that have criminal records, we do expungements clinics. So we would love to try to work with your folk to get their records expunged so that way they be a little bit more freely to work.
Come on down! We love to have you.
I don't think there's any more questions, so why don't we watch the next video and then there might be some additional questions after that.
Okay. This is little something I put together. So
It's coming.
This is what I put together. It's going to show the instructors and the financial counselors working with the guys, and it's going to show the vibe of GBTC.
Take a phone call, so if I miss any part of your financial discussions, I apologize. But how are you funding all of this? And does, and I, on a personal note, I have a nephew who went to CPCC and got his training. He's an electrician, quote unquote, but he couldn't pass the test. Would there be a way that he could come to you to get guidance on how to pass that test?
Yes. First question, you said how I'm funding the school. We partner with Swara Spirit Outreach, which is a 501c3 that donates to Global Vocational Training Center. You can go to swaraspiritoutreach.com, and not only is Swara Spirit Outreach feeding and clothing the community, but they also is helping educate the community. So to 501c3 is donating and giving to Global Vocational Training Center. Also, International Electrical Solutions, the electrical company, is also donating to the 501c3 to donate to Global Vocational Training Center. And each and every one of y'all can either mentor, sponsor, Going to the Global Vocational Training Center.com website and donate to Global Vocational Training Center. Sponsor a man or a woman or a boy or a girl. And you was asking about the test also. He can come to Global Vocational Training Center, but he has to go through the curriculum. That way I can guarantee that if he do the right steps, that we can show him how to pass that test. We got to get him in the zone. He got to study. He got to eat, sleep, and think electrician. And I got the necessary information from when I took the test that he can study to pass that test. Send it to me.
Thank you for the wonderful presentation. And my question is, I'm so proud of what you're doing here in Charlotte. It's just phenomenal. But as you think about throughout this country, different cities, they've tried to do the same thing. And they have been short-lived. They started and they find out that they can't keep it going. So what has been your success to keep it going year after year?
I guess it's a drive in me that I see that this is needed. And whatever there's a great need, then you got to put soldiers on the battlefield to do this. Because this is not only a natural battle, but this is a spiritual battle. The reason why I say that, because the empowerment part that we put in here, we got to empower these guys to be successful. And when these guys graduate, they're going to tell their friends. And we're going to have a big graduation where this community can see that these guys made it. The ones that they said they couldn't make it, made it. So the community is going to see a need for this. And I'm going to stay on the battlefield with this. We're doing another one of these schools in Marvin, North Carolina, outside of Waynesboro, in between Waynesboro and Rockingham. We're going to go to Baltimore and do one of these. We're looking at Baltimore. So I'm sure that if I stay on the battlefield, if the instructors that I hire, they're soldiers, like I said, we just deal with gurus. All I want is gurus. All I want is soldiers. Because this is a great work to be done in our community. Because there's so much many oppositions against this. If it was not so, it would have been happening. You take soldiers to go out here and do this. And I'm a soldier. I'm not going to give up. This is my mission in life. And I feel that if every one of us was to get in our definite mission that we would sit on this earth to do, then the Most High is going to support us and stand behind me.
Chair, am I allowed to sneak in two questions, or is it just one per?
Yes, one.
Thank you. All right, so two questions for you. Number one, if you had to like quantify how much it costs for one student to attend, graduate, and then get their tools as well, I would like you to put like a dollar amount on that if you could. And then the second question is, as people are funneled into this program and you think about like the efforts that go into raising this money, have you all like thought of any type of lobbying at the state level, at the city level, at the county level?
The funding for this program, when these guys come to me, anybody that comes to me, they want to get this program and sit down with me, they ask me how much it costs. I tell them it doesn't cost them nothing. But behind the scenes, it costs $7,000 per student, behind the scenes. That means they get their books, they get $400 worth of tools, they get a job, and they get the full quality training. NCCER training is some of the best technical trade training out there. If you Google NCCER and look at the map of all the training facilities of NCCER, it's going to bog your computer down. I can pull it up and show you. NCCER is spreading like a wildfire. It's very good training. So that is the cost. But up front, it's no cost to them. We will. I trust that we will get the money. I trust that so much. And your second question is?
Lobbying at the different various government levels, the state level, the city level, the county level.
Yes, we had a meeting with the city, like I said before, with Kevin Dix. We had a meeting with Kevin Dix. I'm waiting for Jail Central to call me. I'm waiting for them to call me. I'm waiting for Kevin Dix to get back with me. We're going to be setting up more of these forms where you can come into the school and actually see what's going on in the school. So we gaining momentum now and trying to get this out there. And once we get to a certain level, then we go into Marvin and going to do it in Marvin, North Carolina. So I need your help. I need all of y'all's help.
Well, we don't have any more questions, so let's give them a round of applause. And then Winston.
What kind of support are you getting from contractors and people who hire, you know, electrician, builders, contractors, or whatever? What kind of support are you getting from them?
Well, we have teamed with Arrow Tech here in Charlotte, North Carolina. They are a temp agency that can put the guys to work out with different companies. We're getting great support from them. I'm reaching out to the local 379 union. I used to work for them, so we're going to have a meeting with them and reach out to them and pipeline some guys to the local union. We have not touched every basis yet, but it's on the agenda. Like I said, with Diana Davis, she's great. She's doing the public promises for me, and she's doing an excellent job. So we're coming. Yeah. We're coming.
So beyond people being released from jail or prison, what about, let's say, just a kid maybe in his mid-20s just looking to find his way, even like a college graduate or something, just that population where you might not see the concern, but it's there. Is it reasonable? Is it a reasonable process for them to get into your class, or do you have to have, I guess, just that, you know, that felony, or can anybody just come?
Anybody can come. We take veterans, we take dislocated workers, anybody looking to get into a trade. What I would really like to do is go to West Charlotte High School and start this at their junior year. Basic electrical at their junior year. By the time they graduate, then they can move on into electrical one, electrical two, and then be ready to take their electrician test. One more thing, like I said, like you seen in the video, you seen the little the Latino, 14 years old, his dad worked with me, brought him to me and said, please train and hire people without a family, people that's looking for a trade, people that's looking for a job.
So let me add, Ms. Carlania Irie, how was the process of getting West Charlotte to have the cosmetology program? And is it possible, you think, to incorporate the HVAC and electrical training into a high school like West Charlotte?
The only thing that you can do is we can ask, and I'll be more than happy to help you
ask, because I'm thinking about the CTE program. And my question I was just asking Laura is, have you talked to anyone at West Charlotte? And it probably needs to be someone above that, but I'll be more than happy to help you make the contacts, because my question is, why not? I'll put you in touch with Ernest Winston.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, and then I'll help you follow through.
Thank you. I want to say, we got another question. Okay.
I just wanted to say, have you checked out Philip Berry High School, because it has like engineering program and information technology program, and they already have like some of this in place, and I think it'd be a good place to start.
Okay, then me and you can connect together, make it happen, right? Come and see me. I'm serious. I know you're laughing, but I'm serious. All right. Any other questions?
Any other questions for our speaker this morning? Okay, let's give him a round of applause.
Can I say this before I sit down right quick? I need each and every one of you on this. Let's not just get excited today. Come by and see us. You got a call on the table. You got the address. We there. I usually get there at 4 o'clock. I'm there until 9 p.m. The trades are back. The trades is the quickest way that I think to bring a community out of poverty. The trade is the quickest way to open up your own business. And the trade will slow down that door of incarceration. Thank you.
Thank you. So before we go to announcements, we're going to let Senator Waddell, who's with us today, have a few words.
Thank you very much. It was so great to be here today. They gave us 2 days off while they secretly work on what they do with the budget. So when I come back tomorrow, we probably have a surprise. That's what we're working on, the budget now. That's what basically they are working on. And we've already put in our ask, the things that we want to see. So it's going now to a conference committee between the Senate and the House. And we'll see what they've come up with. But I thank you so much for all of you who advocated for the things that you wanted to see. We're not in the long session, but after the budget, things start slowing down. So, we've had some things in for Mecklenburg County, and we've been proud of those, but not nearly enough. So we're going to see what the budget will bring forth to us. We're working each and every day very hard for you in the North Carolina General Assembly. Our numbers, well, they've increased some. You know, before we had only 15, you can't do much with 15 people when they have 35. Now we have 21, so we're doing a little bit better. One of the biggest things that will be coming forth to us is the abortion bill. They call it Born Alive. Yeah. Now, we've already had it in the Senate. The House keeps delaying it, so when we come back Wednesday, we think they will have voted on it. But I thank you for those of you who've called, who've sent letters, and who've even come down to the General Assembly. It makes a difference, and it helps. So stay tuned. And keep the letters coming for the things that you want from Mecklenburg County and the city of Charlotte. While I'm talking, I want to let you know that this coming Sunday takes a little bit of money to have to keep. I was running that up and down the road, and my suitcase has to be packed all the time. Car got to be full of gas because you don't know when the governor will call you back. And so, this Sunday at 3 at the International House, we have a talent extravaganza, and many of you will be participating. We have just a lot of local talent. Come out, help us, and support us, and keep us in Raleigh. Speaking for you.
Any announcements? We'll come around with the microphone.